Please welcome to the stage, founder and president of Insomniac Games and Academy of Interactive Arts and Sciences Vice Chairman, Ted Price.
Hey, everybody. Hello. All right. This is an amazing crowd, by the way. And I gotta say, it is a real honor to be here with all of you tonight to celebrate the 26th annual D.I.C.E. Awards. And man, 26, that is a lot of years, right? But you know, even though a lot has changed in the industry since that very first show, what hasn't changed is how what we all make connects people. And to get personal for just a moment, I've got four kids. And over the last 20 years, when they've been growing up, we have connected through video games. And we still do that today. I'll call my daughter in Seattle, and we'll talk about stats for Spellswords and Elden Ring. Or I'll be sitting at lunch with my youngest, playing Marvel Snap, and bemoaning the fact that I can never get Black Cat. Games is our shared language. And obviously, games is the language we all use to connect here at D.I.C.E. And it's the language we use to connect with the millions of fans that play our games every single day. Now, speaking of connecting with our fans, what's been especially heartening this year is seeing the industry's increasing efforts to make games more accessible to all audiences. So, for example, right? That's amazing. And as an example, just look at God of War Ragnarok. In setting a new standard, right? I'll let everybody applaud for God of War, right? Amazing game. In setting a new standard for accessibility, Santa Monica Studios is ensuring that anybody can go on this epic journey with Kratos and Atreus. And by the way, I'm not using God of War because I'm a little biased towards Sony. Okay, I'm a little biased towards Sony. Or because I platinumed the game. And I did platinum the game, and it is awesome. So everybody should platinum this game. I'm serious. I'm using it as an example because it shows that every game can do right by all of their players. Every game can create new connections for those who may have felt excluded before. Now, I personally believe that increasing accessibility is a responsibility that we have as creators. We need to welcome every player. But as we all know, this industry we all love still places plenty of challenges when it comes to being a welcoming place to work. We haven't been consistently successful in creating inclusive, diverse, and safe workplaces. And these three issues, inclusivity, diversity, and safety, are crucial topics that we've been discussing here at D.I.C.E., especially at the roundtables. And it's really on all of us to take back these lessons that we've shared to the organizations where we work and to do better. I believe, though, as we look inward and we strive to improve culturally, we can become a more welcoming industry. One that can become a long-term, equitable home for anyone who loves our craft, regardless of race, gender, sexual orientation, or even country of origin. So. Now, speaking of different countries, over the last 3 years, geographic boundaries have basically been erased. And when it comes to how we work, things have changed. Game teams are interacting daily with members who are thousands of miles apart. And this has been a massive, and I would argue mostly positive change for a lot of us. But being globally connected means that we're also more painfully aware of the suffering that our coworkers may be experiencing in times of tragedy. And I can think of no better example than the war in Ukraine, which started right about this time last year when Russia invaded Ukraine. Now, many of us have seen the lives of our coworkers and our friends torn apart by this conflict. And just like last year, we stand in solidarity with Ukraine. So, for all of you here and for anybody who's watching, if you'd like to help, you can visit the Academy's website at www.interactive.org, and there you're going to find information about organizations who are on the front lines of providing assistance. So tonight, We remember our colleagues who have been affected by this strife and other tragic events around the world, like the recent earthquakes in Syria and Turkey. And because we can take advantage of these global bonds our craft enables, all of us can help. And again, you can go to the Academy website to learn more. So please do. Ultimately, though, these bonds between all of us, this deep sharing with our peers and with our players, is what I love about this industry. It's what brings us, I would argue, the entire world closer together when there are so many forces trying to tear us apart. So tonight, let's celebrate these connections, whether we're sitting next to our peers and friends here at the tables at DICE or watching from thousands of miles away. Let's cheer together for these wonderful works of art that bridge divides and connect us all. So thank you and have a great show.
Welcome to the 26th Annual DICE Awards. And now, welcome your hosts, Stella Chung and Greg Miller.
What's up, Vegas? Welcome to the 2023 Annual DICE Awards.
And congratulations to Elden Ring.
No, we're not. Not yet. They gotta hang out a lot longer. Of course. We can't talk about 2023 and not talk about Elden Ring. Please give it up, of course, come on. If you haven't been paying attention, there are two types of people who played Elden Ring. One who didn't finish it, and the other group, a bunch of people on Twitch who somehow beat it with just a banana and a tennis racket.
And a DDR pad.
Or worst of all, a keyboard and mouse.
We're not gonna go there, but now a bit of housekeeping if we could. We'd like to thank Noodle House for producing tonight's video, including that creative intro. So if any of you need your logo stretched, squished, or recolored, yeah. I can get you a deal. And before we start tonight's show, we just want to assure you that yes, we have guards that will prevent any weird kids from rushing the stage.
If you win an award, there will be no weird children on stage, just weird developers. That is our promise of the DICE Awards, all right. Today's show is going to be a lot like Square Enix. If it goes well, Stella and I will take credit.
Yes.
If it goes badly, we are firing someone.
No, wait, well.
If you're groaning at that one, it's going to be a long night, everybody, all right? Trust me. That's top of the order.
We'll start with Greg, don't worry.
No, thank you, Stella. Thank you.
Yes. This is the 26th Annual DICE Awards. You can tell the DICE Awards are 26 because they're making us all feel terrible by referring to the Wii U as a retro console.
Should have referred to it as a mistake. It's gonna be a long monologue if you keep groaning like this at every one of them. Good Lord. If you haven't noticed, I've hosted this show for years, but it's always very, very emotional for me, and today's no exception. I don't want to bring us down, but it is my 7th time doing the DICE Awards, and thank you. I just really wish Google Stadia could still be here to see it.
I'm sorry.
Taken too soon. It was just taken
sorry. They're in the cloud now.
I know. The cloud. Now, I'm sure many of you are nervous here tonight. Right now, every nominee in the audience is thinking, will I win a trophy? And how do I make HBO turn my game into a show?
That's right. The television adaptation The Last of Us premiered on HBO Max a few weeks ago, and people, including me, absolutely love it.
Television.
Right. Okay. So it's kind of like Twitch streams, but just the cutscenes.
Oh, no. Yeah. No, thank you. I don't like that one bit. That sounds weird.
Okay. All right. But I hope everyone takes a moment to enjoy this night.
Because this may very well be the last time we are all in the room together without knowing what Chris Pratt's Mario actually will sound like.
We've heard a little.
But not enough, right? Like, we really don't know what we're getting into.
There were a lot of big controversies last year, including that. And a video from an early build of Grand Theft Auto 6 was leaked.
It sure was. Everybody who watched it, everybody online was like, I can't believe it looks this terrible. The main character was just running in a gray neutral box.
I really don't think this is the point, but I think we really have to teach people how video games are made, folks.
This isn't for anybody in the room. You get it. Ladies and gentlemen watching, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of hours of podcasts from developers talking about their crafts. For some, God, I don't understand it reason, Tim Schafer just put out 32 episodes of a documentary about this. You need to educate yourselves about what they're doing.
It's too much work.
It isn't! Sorry.
Two of the actors from God of War Ragnarok are nominated tonight, both Christopher Judge and Sunny Suljic. You know, when I see these two so proud of each other and so happy to be working together, I think, man, I've got daddy issues.
Sure. Stella, the good news is we all do. And Christopher, if you win tonight, you can talk as long as you want to, daddy. Give it to us, Daddy!
So I saw that Trombone Champ is nominated for Family Game of the Year.
It sure is, Trombone Champ.
Yeah, if you haven't played it, it is such a fun game. It's really silly, and it's a game in which you struggle with weird controls to play public domain trombone songs.
It's really the video game version of Ian Malcolm in Jurassic Park saying your scientists were so preoccupied with whether they could, they didn't stop to think if they should.
But I'm glad they did. Although, I know Trombone Champ isn't very realistic, because in a realistic version, you're going to get stuffed into a locker.
Sure. I think that one didn't play at all.
Where are the shots?
That was the first flat one of the night. Do you want Fireball or Jameson? Jameson? Ooh, we knew it was going to be rough out there. But good Lord.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. I was expecting the Jameson. If I'm being honest, I was expecting the Jameson.
I knew you were weak, but I didn't know you were this weak. Impressive.
I'm sorry, second daddy.
Seven years?
Second daddy.
7 years.
Let's get back to it. I think that this is, again, still, we're still in the Trombone Champ section. Everybody, just stick with us. Shuhei, I see you out there. I need you to hold strong with me, all right? Jeez Louise. I think they put it, Trombone Champ, in the category Family Game of the Year, because the more you play the game, the more confused your family gets.
You tried.
Is there a bartender in here? Because we need another one. The Trombone Champ was not the way to go.
You did your best.
I tried.
Yeah, you know what? Let's talk about another indie game that everyone seemed to really love, Vampire Survivors. Yeah, Vampire Survivors is nominated for multiple awards tonight. And if you remember, the early versions of the game were made by just one person. Just one. Yeah, that one. Yeah, so if it wins Game of the Year, a lot of executives are gonna lose their minds.
Of course, yeah. Work from home. That guy did it, and the game did pretty well, so maybe keep it, you know what, I'll let it go. Diablo Immortal is nominated for Mobile Game of the Year. Now, some people complained Diablo Immortal had too many microtransactions, which kind of makes sense because he is the devil.
You mean Diablo?
No, Bobby Kotick. I still got it!
That makes up for the trombone champion.
Bring it up. They forgot about trombone. We're able to move on.
Never forget about it. But honestly, enough from us. This night is about you, the amazing artists, musicians, designers, actors, directors, everyone who makes games possible.
Without all of you, of course, the world would be a much darker place.
And we wouldn't have jobs, so also thank you.
Great point for that. So please give it up for yourselves, everybody. 2023 DICE Award nominees.
You deserve it most of all, and thank you from the bottom of our hearts for making some of the best games of all time.
And tonight, we have two people here, Rory and Miha, two of the scholars, ladies and gentlemen, from DICE. They're joining us on the stage to give away awards tonight, so please make them feel welcome when they come out to give them out.
Yeah. Let's give them a round of applause, because sometime soon they'll be up here accepting their own awards, which is amazing. We're setting up the future.
I hope we're still hosting.
You know, sorry, we'll get there.
Ah, damn, all right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, now for our first presenter of the evening.
Founder and president of Haven Entertainment,
Jade Raymond.
Action. From epic poems to big screen blockbusters, action is one of the oldest and most popular genres. And the games industry is no different. Actually, there is one important difference. In other mediums, we watch action heroes. In games, we are the action heroes. Through games, we get to dodge bullets, fight giant bugs, and seek vengeance, all from the comfort of our homes. The nominees for Action Game of the Year are...
The nominees for Action Game of the Year are... Bayonetta 3.
Don't worry, I know this song by heart.
If we don't stop them, this world is history.
Grounded. Neon White. Sifu. Vampire Survivors.
And the winner is Vampire Survivors.
We're not Luca, sorry. No. but we are delighted and grateful to accept this award on behalf of the Vampire Survivors team at Ponkle. Luca, the creator of the game, asked us to thank the Ponkle team for all of their hard work on Vampire Survivors, from the initial launch, porting to new platforms, and their continued work back home in the UK. They've been absolutely incredible. Secondly, thank you to the fans and the community of Vampire Survivors. Without them, we wouldn't be where we are today, and we'll be forever thankful and grateful for their time, comments, and commitment to that 100% save file. We'd also like to thank the Academy of Interactive Arts and Sciences for this prestigious award. It's a great honor to receive it this evening and be placed alongside so many other hardworking development teams. And lastly, to all of our partners across the globe, we thank you for your advice, time, and expertise. Here's to all the garlic along the way. Thank you so much.
Adventure games are all about the journey. Some of the journeys are new stories in old sagas. Others surprise us with new perspectives, like that of a cat traversing through a post-human robot society. But regardless of what they're about, each of the nominees tonight gave us a journey we'll never forget. Those games are...
The nominees for Adventure Game of the Year are... God of War, Ragnarok. Horizon Forbidden West. Norco. Stray. Tunic.
And the winner is God of War, Ragnarok.
Wow. I'm not used to being up on stage like this, so pardon me. But I got to thank the Academy and everybody who voted for us and got us up there. I mean, at SMS, we are always thinking about how to make this game not just an action game, not just a narrative game, not just puzzles everywhere. And winning this award, to me, makes me feel like it's all our teams in our studio coming together to make the product work, and all our external partners as well. I can't rattle them all off, it's too many. But this is like a team award, and I'm happy to accept this on behalf of SMS. Thank you.
Please welcome to the stage, Andrea Renee, host and co-founder of What's Good Games.
It can be easy to forget that the gameplay elements we used to consider the domain of RPGs have spread into just about every other genre. I mean, think about it. What game these days doesn't have stat allocation and skill trees? Whether you're tuning up your car in a racing game or you're upgrading your loadout in first-person shooters, we're all more than used to leveling up and choosing new abilities. But traditional role-playing games exist for a reason. We become more than just numbers. We become epic heroes and grand tales, where our decisions guide the fate of distant lands, whether on Earth, space, or even the lands between. The nominees are...
The nominees for role-playing game of the year are... Citizen Sleeper.
What if we can find this?
That's Knife on the Eye.
Elden Ring. Weird West. World of Warcraft, Dragonflight. Xenoblade Chronicles 3.
And the winner of role-playing game of the year is Elden Ring.
Yeah.
素晴らしい賞をいただいてありがとうございます。エルデンリングアクション RPG なんですけど、実はですね、我々なりに、まあ、秘密裏にロールプレイというキーワードには結構こだわってきたつもりなので、まあ、ベスト RPG いただけて非常に嬉しいです。
It's a great pleasure receiving this wonderful award. And obviously we are really an action RPG teamWe're really, really addicted to this genre, so it's really, really great that we received this award.
ありがとうございます。本当にありがとうございます。
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Video games often have us playing fantasy roles.We can be spies, rock stars, even gods. But when it comes to strategy and simulation games, we can also fulfill our wildest fantasies of micromanagement. Yes! Whether it's overseeing a dwarven colony, a futuristic space station, an alchemist shop, an army of space marines, or a team of superheroes, tonight's nominees allow us to ignore our real-world chores to complete seemingly endless fictional ones. These are the nominees.
The nominees for Strategy / Simulation Game of the Year are Dwarf Fortress, Ixion, Marvel's Midnight Suns, Potioncraft Alchemist Simulator.40,000 Chaos Gate Daemon Hunters.
Come at me, heretics! You will be cleansed. Face your judgment.
And the winner is Dwarf Fortress.
On behalf of my brother, the genius, we couldn't have done this without the fans who supported us for 20 years.
Oh my God.
Just for no reason. They didn't have to give us any money. But they did. And then a publisher picked us up.
Yep.
Tanya Shorey, Kid Fox Games, and made this for everyone. Everyone can play this now, not just people that.Can read ASCII and program in Linux, everyone. So thank you. Thanks.
Welcome back our hosts, Stella Chung and Greg Miller.
Belinda Garcia, the ultimate hype woman.
Oh my God, I love it. That's my wife that you're speaking about.
I appreciate it. Now, what I don't think you guys understood about the trombone jokes.
All right, let's just. The best things come in threes, and that holds true for the following categories.
Here are the nominees and winners for Online Game of the Year, Outstanding Technical Achievement, and Immersive Reality Technical Achievement.
The nominees for Online Game of the Year are.Call of Duty, Modern Warfare 2. EA Sports FIFA 23.
Advantage in operation. Taking care of business defensively here.
might be able to set up the chance.
Final Fantasy XIV Endwalker. Come on!
As the chaos spread.
Marvel Snap. Rumbleverse. The winner is Final Fantasy XIV Endwalker.
Do as you must, then, but we Scions will fight until the heavens fall, until our last breath.
The nominees for Outstanding Technical Achievement are A Plague Tale Requiem.
Leave it to me.
Kill that girl!
Elden Ring. God of War, Ragnarok. Horizon Forbidden West. Teardown. Winner is Elden Ring.
Rise, tarnished. Rise and become the Elden Lord.
The nominees for Immersive Reality Technical Achievement are Among Us VR. Cosmonius High. Moss, Book 2. Red Matter 2.
I can't believe it worked. I can't control it.
The Last Clockwinder. And the winner is Red Matter 2.
Well, graveyard isn't what we were led to believe.
My reports show nothing. Do you read me, Sasha?
Please welcome to the stage game director at Housemarque of last year's DICE Award winner Returnal, Harry Krueger.
The key to audio design is all the sound you don't really think about, but would immediately notice if it wasn't there. Things like the metallic snap as you pull the pin of a grenade, or the growl of the engine as you ride off to the next mission. Things like the gentle breeze and distant creature noises as you explore a mysterious alien forest. Without the work of the dedicated and talented audio designers nominated tonight, the silence would be deafening. So the nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Audio Design are...
The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Audio Design are... A Plague Tale Requiem.
Wait.
Call of Duty, Modern Warfare 2.
As long as there is a war on terror, there will be no real war on drugs.
God of War Ragnarok. Gotham Knights. Somerville.
And the winner is... God of War, Ragnarok.
I do, I got it. Well, thanks, everyone. Just on behalf of all of PlayStation, we'd like to thank the Academy for this one. Sorry, I have to write this down. I don't ever read things. I record them. Congrats to all of our nominees, our fellow nominees. All of your craft and your amazing work makes our entire industry better, and it was just amazing to be nominated with all of you. We'd like to accept this award on behalf of the entire PlayStation Studios audio team and the Santa Monica Studios audio team. And a huge shout out to Eric and Yumi and Chad. You guys were fantastic to work with. Everyone on God of War was just fantastic to develop with. A special shout out to our cast. You guys are amazing. I'll work with you any day. And yeah.
So thanks to all our partners, Sweet Justice, Molinaire, Boom Libraries, Formosa, and Side. Never failed to deliver with us. We'd also like to thank our producers, localization team, publishing partners at Sony. We couldn't have done it without you as well. And finally, we'd like to recognize our families and friends for all the support during this development cycle. Thanks.
Music is an inseparable part of the emotional journey players embark on in our games. I think many of our most cherished moments in gaming are often accompanied by equally memorable music. Music can elevate the intensity of a climactic battle. It can celebrate our triumphs and help pull on those heartstrings during some of the more dramatic story moments we experience in our favorite medium. Sometimes music can even be so captivating that we just leave the titled screen on just to listen to our favorite track on repeat. Tonight's nominees continue the tradition of making games more memorable through music. And the nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Music Composition are...
The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Original Music Composition are... A Plague Tale Requiem. God of War, Ragnarok. Horizon Forbidden West. Metal, Hellsinger. Moss, Book 2.
and the winner is God of War Ragnarok.
Oh, this is awesome. I want to say it's just an honor to accept this award on behalf of so many wonderful and talented individuals. Number one, Bear McCreary, who just wrote an incredible score. He and his wife have a new baby, and so he's busy with that. He's on another project right now. So. I'd also like to thank our Creative Arts music team for all the long hours, the passion. It takes a lot of work to get the music working the way it does in the game, and I just couldn't be more proud of the team for all that effort. Santa Monica Studio, I just can't say enough about what a wonderful opportunity it is for us to partner with you and just the great games that you make. Yumi, Eric, Chad, Ken, Corey, everyone there, we just really, really appreciate it. And to our creative arts exec team, I just want to call them out. Richard Herman, Dave, Scott, and my brothers, my work brothers Chuck and Keith, just to your commitment to quality. We really appreciate it. And thanks so much, everyone.
One more time, ladies and gentlemen, please. I really get a feeling that table's only clapping for you, though, when we come out, you know?
As they should.
That's like, thank you, Belinda. Our next presenter not only has a rich history in gaming, he also has a wonderful first name. One that exudes strength, elegance, bravery, not to mention smarts, if I do say so myself.
Oh, that's so cool. You don't meet many men named Stella.
No.
Oh.
Please give a warm welcome to head of PlayStation creators at Sony Interactive Entertainment, Greg Rice.
Today, I have the pleasure of introducing your 2023 DICE Hall of Fame recipient, the man, the myth, the Tim of legend, Tim Schafer. When I heard Tim was being presented with this award, my first thought was honestly, doesn't he have this already? Because he should. It's impossible to overstate the impact Tim has had on this industry. Like many of you, I grew up playing Tim's masterpieces from LucasArts. The games he worked on there had a caliber of writing, voice acting, and artistry that was unmatched. And he helped create and define the entire genre of adventure games. Now, that would have been enough for most, but Tim didn't rest there, and he went off on his own adventures, founding Double Fine Productions on the core principles of creativity and craft. I somehow found myself lucky enough to have the pleasure of spending a decade at Double Fine, and it granted me a peek behind the curtains to where I can confirm that Tim is not only a creative genius, but he's 100% the kind, caring, and thoughtful leader that you all hope he is. The thing I admire about Tim and his work at Double Fine is not just the incredible games that they've made together, but it's the way that they go about it. Tim and everybody at Double Fine genuinely care about each other. It's a highly collaborative environment that understands good ideas can come from anywhere, and everyone is really encouraged to think outside the box. So this is evident in the company's Amnesia Fortnite game jam, where for 2 weeks, the company sets aside everything it's working on and mixes things up, allowing everybody to try out a new trade or pitch a game idea of their own. Some of the company's best games have started with this process and exist because of Tim letting others take the lead and helping to cultivate their talent. Tim's focus on creativity and experimentation also extends to how Double Fine games are marketed and even how the company does business. I remember clearly the DICE 11 years ago, where we launched the world record-breaking Double Fine Adventure Kickstarter campaign that helped legitimize a whole new way to finance indie games. This project and the development and the supporting Double Fine documentary helped really further the deep connection that he had with his community and granted an entire new generation of developers an unprecedented look at the video game development process so others could be learning and inspired. And with Double Fine Presents and Day of the Devs, Tim has shown a commitment to the wider game development community and shining a spotlight on other people making great games and helping foster a connection to their communities. Now, that's not to say Double Fine hasn't had its share of challenges, some of which have been very publicly documented, but through it all, Tim was able to keep things positive, be a rock for the studio, and most importantly, always put the well-being of his employees and their families first. It truly does feel like a family at Double Fine, and as impressive as their games are, I'd say the people who have come up under Tim and the talent that he's cultivated in them are equally impressive. People like Lee Petty of Stacking, Headlander, and Rad fame, yeah, and many other impeccably talented creatives that are working with inside those walls to create the next great wave of Double Fine games. And then there are the former Double Fine employees who are lead creatives and executives at Google, Meta, Valve, Epic, Pixar, Microsoft, PlayStation, and more. That's right, Tim has infiltrated all of your businesses with people who lead with creativity and passion. And yes, there is a code word that he will say at some point that makes us all Voltron up and do his biddings. But until that happens, I am so glad to see Tim so happy. Psychonauts 2 was a masterpiece, and the future is very bright. Yes. I'm really happy to see them with the support of Xbox allowing Double Fine to let their creativity loose. So please join me in honoring Tim and taking a look at his incredible career.
Tim Schafer has been many things to the world of video games. An adventurer, a comic, a writer, a boss, an employee, and a tour guide at Skywalker Ranch. But most importantly, a force of creativity in games. High school Tim had a variety of interests, ranging from maintaining his badass garage band cred to being a secret computer club member. But the thing that would start his passion in video games was the day his dad brought home a brand spanking new Magnavox Odyssey. Attending UC Berkeley for computer science, Tim really wasn't sure what he was going to do after graduation. When offered exciting opportunities to pursue a career in either lab testing, database maintenance, or writing hilarious adventure games, he chose the one that fit best. Database maintenance. Luckily for the video game industry, Tim saw a job posting at Lucasfilm Games for a programmer who could also write dialogue. So of course, he nearly destroyed it all in his interview with David Fox. As only a confident 20-year-old could, Tim proudly but ignorantly proclaimed his fandom to the game Ball Blaster, the pirated version of LucasArts Ball Blazer. For this second impression, Tim was out to impress. On his job application, he added a little adventure game he wrote and printed. Tim was hired on and was introduced to fellow game tester Dave Grossman. Eventually, the pair was recruited by Ron Gilbert to work on his new project, The Secret of Monkey Island, where they would add much of the humor and character that made fans adore the game. With some success behind them, Tim and Dave were made co-leads on another successful production, Day of the Tentacle. Tim was next tasked with directing a game of his very own, so he did what anyone would do and made a hard-hitting dystopian heavy metal biker adventure game. Full Throttle launched in 1995, and gamers loved it. Tim soon followed Full Throttle with a fantastic underworld concept, Grim Fandango, launching in 1998, which would go on to win multiple Game of the Year awards. With the winds of success filling his sails, it was time to set his eyes on a golden new horizon. The year was 2000. Y2K didn't happen. Tim created a game company called Double Fine with a handful of folks from LucasArts and a second handful of new folks. Their first project was to be the smash hit Psychonauts. In 2009, Brutal Legend was unleashed upon the metal-loving gamers of the world, complete with Jack Black, hard rock, and of course, flamethrowers. Perhaps one of Tim's most inventive inventions was not a video game, but a tradition called Amnesia Fortnite. A 2-week-long pitch-a-thon, where for the mere price of a cup of coffee in 1967, anyone could vote for their favorite concept. Many of the prototypes went on to become beloved titles, like Costume Quest, Iron Brigade, Stacking, and Once Upon a Monster. In that same pioneering spirit, Tim managed to set a crowdfunding world record, raising $3 million to make Broken Age. But more importantly, success of this magnitude paved the way for future successes, both for Double Fine and the rest of the industry. After over 20 years as an independent studio, a milestone few studios reach, Double Fine and Tim joined Microsoft in 2019 and were reunited with many friends and colleagues in the industry where an unannounced Grim Fandango Master Chief crossover is currently in production. Tim and Double Fine continue to be ambassadors for independent development, creating indie celebrations like the decade-long run of Day of the Devs. Tim continues to be one of the most dedicated creators in our industry. His contributions define trends and shape the future. He has become a true conduit for creativity and innovation in our craft. For his achievements, for taking us on adventures, making us laugh, and for his continued passion for the art of video games, tonight we honor Tim Schafer as the 2023 inductee to the AIAS Hall of Fame. Please welcome Tim Schafer.
Thank you. Do I take this down? Oh, thank you. Oh, no. Please. Please, everybody. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Greg. Please remain standing. I mean, if I have to stand up. It feels much better. It really helps you. No, okay, you can sit down. I was going to say, thank you. I love you, too. I'll make this quick, but it really is a great time to use the restroom. If, like, before Game of the Year, this is an awesome time because I'll talk that video. But I want to thank Greg for that beautiful talk. That was amazing. The journey up to here has been fraught with a lot of near-death financial experiences, and Greg has definitely helped us survive a lot of those. So thank you, Greg. Get the first one. I plan to talk really eloquently, but now I feel like I just sit here and catch my breath for 4 minutes together while we're all quiet. Thank you so much for all of you, all my colleagues. I've been coming to DICE and other shows for so many years, seeing you all, so many friends and supporters here. And also, it's so nice to see my long list of enemies and haters. I'm so glad that you're here to see my ultimate victory over you. Thank you. Represented by this beautiful trophy representing the Vulcan lacrosse team. Thank you so much. Really quick thanks. I'm going to start at the very beginning. I got to thank my parents. This is corny. We're here. Whatever. It's fun. My mom, my dad, my mom for setting up a craft table in our family room, because every day we were just invited to make up stuff, and there's a table that was just covered with like glue and pom-pom balls and like paper, and we were just invited to think that every day could be a creative day, and that's really important, something that kept with me all my life. So thanks to my mom for that, and thank you. And to my dad for all the many things he did, but of course bringing home that Magnavox Odyssey and getting me obsessed, driving me down to Mill Valley to the computer store to buy video games and Ziploc baggies. So many supportive things he did to get me excited about, and accepting that I would never become a doctor, but do this instead. Real quick, my seventh grade English professor, Mr. Harrington, you're not professor, seventh grade, what am I talking about? For teaching me free writing, which is something I do, where you just write every day and you don't think about it. I still do it to this day. I mean, I think about doing it every day. I don't have the like patience and discipline to do it every day, but like I think about you and Mr. Harrington every day. And my creative writing teacher from high school, Ms. Adams, who encouraged me, said you really need to write more. And I was thinking about that, and recently I realized that she's saying I need to practice more, which maybe it wasn't. But anyway, I did it, so thanks, Ms. Adams. Thanks to UC Santa Cruz and UC Berkeley for, yeah, go Bear Slugs. For being fucking free. Like people don't know this. Back then, UC had no tuition. So I want to thank the taxpayers of California for paying for my college, right? Yeah. which brought me to the Career Center where I saw a job listing from LucasArts for programmers who like creative writing. Perfect, amazing job, and I landed at LucasArts to be mentored by people like David Fox, and thanks for hiring me, David Fox, even though I totally pirated all your games, and it's even worse than that. But whatever. David Fox, Ron Gilbert, Noah Falstein, and Hal Barwood, who taught me so much about writing and creativity, and to imagine being dropped into this amazing job where they're like, well, we have all this money from Star Wars, we don't know what to do with it, because we can't make Star Wars games, we just have to make a bunch of shit up, and we don't know what to do. So it's like, wow, that's a fun job. And it got me addicted to making up cool new stuff with other people's money all my life. So just definitely do that. I'm gonna wrap this up real quick. So, and to those next projects, people often ask me, do you have any regrets in your career? And I always like, I don't, because I got to make all of the games I like, and I'm really happy, and I feel really lucky and privileged to be making all the games. But I do have some regrets. I pretend I've learned nothing, but I have learned some things over this career, and I do regret, if anything, those next few projects, Full Throttle and Gryffindango and Psychonauts, I regret the terrible crunch modes I put those teams through. So I want to apologize to all the teams of my early games for the terrible crunch modes I put them through, because I didn't mean it, but a lot of us in those days were just kind of acting the way we did in college, which is staying up all night in computer labs to finish our software projects. And we dragged a lot of people through some terrible, it has a big effect. Crunch mode has a terrible effect on your mental health and your health and your relationships and all these things. And hopefully we learn each time, we do better. And I'm just so lucky that I made all those mistakes back before accountability had been invented. Like, right? I'm seriously so lucky. All the teams that gave me a second chance, all those second chances to get a little better with every game and to fight that. We're still fighting in this industry, fighting crunch mode all the time. It's not a good thing, but it's hard. It's a whole. We'll talk about that next time. And thanks. And I want to thank the Xbox for being launched right when I launched my company and making it so easy to sign Psychonauts and start that crazy 20-year relationship with Microsoft on again, off again, that ended with us being part of the Xbox family. So I want to thank Noah Musler at our table and Mary McGuane and Matt Booty and Phil Spencer for seeing value in Double Fine and bringing us into that really nice space and letting us just stay as weird as we are. And it's been a few years now, and they've really been true to their word and let us stay Double Fine, even though we were part of that family. So thank you to them. And thank you most of all to the Double Fine employees and the team there. It's amazing. I feel so amazed I get to work with such a creative group who put so much love into the game, so much talent, but also so much care for each other. And they really support each other and look out for each other. And it makes working with them so rewarding. And I want to thank all our fans and players. We have the sweetest, most supportive community and have all our times. And nothing would have been possible without them. I want to thank my lovely family, my daughter Lily, and my wife Rachel for staying with me through all the crunches and cancellations all these years. And for no matter what, always being there to remind me that I'm really not a big deal and I should get over myself, so thank you for that. This is how every meeting ends at Double Fine, by the way. It's like, what'd I forget? Okay, so thanks to them. The Xbox players, fans. And I want to thank, I want to take it 1 second before I leave, really quick, to thank Megan Scavio, because she's sitting at our table. Hi. Partially because it'll make her really uncomfortable for everyone to look at her over in table 44. And there's so much that, like, at D.I.C.E. in her previous job, Megan has done to bring us together, not just as professionals, but as human beings, to get to know each other all these years, which makes it so much more bearable. So thank you, Megan, for all the work you do and bringing us together as a community. So thank you, Megan. Thanks to the AIS. Thank you, D.I.C.E. Thank you, all of you. It's a great honor. Good night. Thanks.
Please welcome the co-founder and creative director of Outer Loop Games, the studio behind the upcoming Thirsty Suitors, Chandra Ekanayaka.
Wow, I gotta follow that. Okay. Congrats, Tim. Hey. All right, come on. If the past few years have shown us, the past few years have done anything for us, it's the hope that hopefully, so you guys are messing me up here, brought us all together with our loved ones. Tonight's nominees for Family Game of the Year There we go. We're catching up now. Have given us shared experiences that are fun for players for all ages, allowing us to spend time together in magical worlds, or give the kids an excuse to laugh at dads stumbling through the worst world version of William Tell Overture ever played on trombone. The nominees for Family Game of the Year are...
The nominees for Family Game of the Year are... Disney Dreamlight Valley. Kirby's Dream Buffet. Lost in Play. Mario Plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope. Trombone Champ.
And the winner is Mario Rabbids Sparks of Hope.
Well, getting on this stage after Tim Schafer is not easy indeed. Well, what happens in Vegas doesn't stay in Vegas in occasions like this, I guess. Please let me thank the Academy, DICE, all the members of the jury for this prestigious recognition. I am accepting this award on behalf of our amazing and talented dev teams at Ubisoft Milan, Paris, Chengdu, Pune, Montpellier, who put so much effort and work into this game, and who poured all their heart and passion in making it funny, enjoyable, heartwarming, and welcoming to players of any age. And please let me thank Nintendo for trusting us once again and for being our partners in this incredible journey. And last but not least, I'd like to thank all my fellow nominees, all the other developers who share with us the love for making video games. Accepting this award is really humbling, but also makes me proud. And I guess that my colleagues and my friends are toasting right now. For some of them, it's the middle of the night on the other side of the ocean. But I guess that they have been sleepless anyway, hoping and waiting for a moment like this. So thank you, everyone. Thank you.
I'm going to try this again. Okay. Racing games are a far wider genre than we give them credit for. Some racing games allow us to have all the fun of having a driver's license without having all the boring rules of the road. Others revel in depth and realism and allow for maximum customization. But however they play, to quote Sonic the Hedgehog, gotta go fast. Here are the nominees.
The nominees for Racing Game of the Year are F1 22. Gran Turismo 7. for Speed Unbound.
And the winner is Gran Turismo 7. Wow, this is amazing. Thank you so much. On behalf of all of PlayStation Studios, and especially the team at Polyphony, who has been doing this for 25 marvelous years, thank you so much. On behalf of Yamauchi-san, who has dedicated so much of his life to the craft of making every single detail on every car absolutely perfect, Polyphony Studios and PlayStation, thanks all of you. Thank you.
Welcome to the stage, co-founder of The Mix and Black Voices in Gaming, and the lead advisor on the Black Game Developer Fund, Justin Woodward.
Yeah. Y'all are lit right now, for sure. Game design is central to everything we do here. It's the way games stay fresh and exciting. It's also hard to describe. How do you define a job that carries the weight of everything from balancing weapons to designing maps to making sure players feel connected to the story and everything happening around them? Game design shows us that if a way of doing something doesn't exist, you can and must create it. The category of outstanding achievement in game design celebrates the desire to always find new ways to give players a fun, compelling experience. Those nominees are...
The nominees for outstanding achievement in game design are... Elden Ring. God of War, Ragnarok. Marvel Snap.
It's clobbering time.
Tunic. Vampire Survivors.
And the winner is Elden Ring.
It's a pleasure receiving this wonderful award.
From Software, we thought it was the largest challenge in the past, so I'm very happy to receive such an award.
Obviously, this is the biggest challenge we have experienced so far, so it's once again it's an honor to receive this wonderful award.
僕のわがままに付き合ってくれた谷村さん、石崎さん、あるいは稲葉さん、有馬さん、海川さん、加藤さんといったところですね、をはじめとした企画チームの面々とこの喜びを分かち合いたいと思います。
And when it comes to game designing, I am obviously demanding, so I need to say my great thank you to the members of the game designing team, including Tanimura-san, Ishizaki-san, Inaba-san, Arima-san, Kayagawa-san, and Kato-san. I really want to share this joy with them. I think they're also happy. I believe they're watching it in Japan. So once again, thank you so much.
Independent games are often the culmination of the dream of a small group of people or even one person. They're a labor of love that begin not in a conference room, but in a garage or a living room or bedroom. Independent games have a greater presence in the gaming landscape than ever before due to the passion and dedication of these talented artists. While we all love a big, huge, and good budget, trust me, I know this personally. The following games prove you can do a whole lot with just a little. The nominees for Outstanding Achievement for an Independent Game are...
The nominees for Outstanding Achievement for an Independent Game are... Immortality. Neon White. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Shredder's Revenge. Tunic. Vampire Survivors.
And the winner is Tunic.
What a five-way toss-up that was. Oh my God. Oh, wow. So I am the one person from the Tunic team who could be here today. I'm the audio director, so go sound, folks. Here we go. I co-run a little team called Power Up Audio in Vancouver, and 7 years back, thanks. One clap over there. Go Power Up Audio. 7 years back, 2015, Andrew Scholdeis, the primary developer on Tunic, came to us and said, hey, I have this macro prototype. I'm gonna throw it all out, but just to give an idea of what it feels like to adventure and such, just have a look, give it a play, what do you think? And there was 6 hours of content, and we're like, who the hell is this guy? What is going on? So we latched on real quick, and 7 years later, that was all stripped away, the majority of it was, but the soul certainly remained. So I gotta say, just as the one guy here, I'm so grateful to Andrew bringing us on board along for this ride. It's amazing. And secondarily, I want to give a big shout to Finji, our partner is the publisher on Tunic as well. Some woos for Finji, thank you. Thank you. Thanks so much. And as well, I mean, I would loathe to forget my wife. Thank you so much. This game was hard to ship, and she, what she went through. Thank you so much. And indeed, to all husband and wives partners out there, as Tim was saying, crunch hurts. Whoops. And, it won't happen again, I promise. I love you so much. Thank you. Thanks so much.
And now, please welcome Creative Director of Future Club, Mariel Cartwright.
Great games let us lose ourselves in the experience, and great art direction makes that illusion tactile. Whether it's a feline strut through the neon streets of a cyberpunk city or breathtaking mechanical beasts in forbidden lands, creating worlds out of whole cloth is no small feat. and creating worlds that keep filling us with wonder, all the more special. The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Art Direction are...
The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Art Direction are... Call of Duty, Modern Warfare 2.
We're a team. These scenes take violence and timing. I can do both.
God of War, Ragnarok. Horizon Forbidden West. Stray. The Callisto Protocol.
There's a way to change that.
And the winner is... God of War Ragnarok.
Hey, thanks everyone. First, we want to thank the Academy for this award. Next, we want to thank PlayStation Studios leadership, SIE leadership, Santa Monica Studio leadership, with a shout out to Corey Barlog and Eric Williams for allowing us to grow and allowing us to be our best each and every day. Next, we want to thank the entire development team that worked on this project, external development, our external partners, partner studios, all of the tremendous artists that worked on this project, also tech art, rendering, everybody had a huge part to play in this, and it really takes everyone to pour themselves into an endeavor such as this game. And then lastly, we want to thank our fans. Your passion and enthusiasm are what drive us every single day. You make it feel special to us, and we want to live up to your bar. So thank you for inspiring us to be our best every day. Thank you so much.
Animation in games helps us connect to the characters, whether it's to the action through their movements on the battlefield, or their emotions with the way they flash a smile or show their pain. It's a form of magic that convinces us that these are real beings in living worlds. How the leaves move in a jungle, how a ship floats in outer space, or even how a door opens and closes, the right animation in a game makes us believe we're there. The nominees are...
The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Animation are... Cuphead, The Delicious Last Course. Elden Ring. God of War, Ragnarok.
Ready?
Horizon Forbidden West. Moss, Book 2.
She must have missed it. Uncle, look out!
Impossible!
And the winner is... God of War Ragnarok.
My
goodness, what a strapping physique.
Boy.
Whew, wow. Thank you so much to the Academy. Thank you, everybody. This project was like truly an animator's dream. We got to animate dragons, a yak, anthropomorphic talking squirrels, and some really sweet father and son moments. So I want to thank the Academy. I want to thank Sony, PlayStation for giving us all the support. Scott Herman, thank you for believing in our team. I want to thank the studio leadership at Santa Monica, Jimmy, Corey, Ken, our studio director. I really want to thank Eric Williams for setting this great template for us to just be creative and animate some amazing things. I really want to thank the entire team at Sony Santa Monica Studio, especially our amazing animation team. I really love working with them every day. They're so passionate, and I'm just really blessed that I have such an amazing team. Thank you. I know you guys are watching. This is for you guys. You guys did this. I really want to thank all our creative partners who also helped us complete so much animation that we just couldn't have done without their help. VASG, thank you for completing, like helping us finish five hours of cinematics, which was really incredible. I want to thank our cast for helping us create these amazing characters, our stunt performers. There's just so many people to thank that really contributed to this. Our leads, Erica, Maddie, Axel, and of course, I can't forget the fans, and most importantly, our families for being there, for supporting us. I want to thank my mom, my father, rest in peace, and of course, my wife, Kyung Hee, I love you, my daughters, Olivia and Sophia. I'm coming home. I'll see you soon. And thank you so much. Have a good night.
Please welcome Ed Boon, the co-creator of Mortal Kombat and last year's recipient of the Hall of Fame Award.
At this point, picking up a controller and going head-to-head with friends in a fighting game is a tradition. For decades, we've chosen our fighters and welcomed all challengers, and why not? Fighting games get the blood pumping. They're all the fun without any of the pain. Instant action and unforgettable characters we love to call our own, or at least pretend we're good at. These are this year's nominees.
The nominees for Fighting Game of the Year are JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, All-Star Battle R.
It's gonna sit.
Multiverses.
Up and away.
I'm out of here.
Shut these fools down, hardcore.
You better not give me.
Let's kick some digital booties.
Rumbleverse. Spider Hack. The King of Fighters 15.
These two know how to run it.
And the winner is Multiverses.
That's all, folks.
Boy, Zoinks, what a matchup.
Get up, Blue!
Wow, this is such an honor. There's so many people I want to thank. You know, I've had the privilege to work with so many talented people over the last couple of years. So many talented developers at PlayerFirst Games that have brought this to life. I also want to thank our publishing partners at Warner Brothers for being incredibly supportive. And I really want to thank our fans for playing the game and their enthusiasm and their energy. This is really just super exciting to see how this has come together. But yeah, just thank you. It's truly an honor.
Games allow us to step into fantasy worlds that we'd never be able to in our normal lives. One example of that is stepping into the shoes of superstar athletes. We may never kick a goal, hit a home run, or nail a last-second three-pointer to the roar of a crowd, but in games, we can. The nominees for Best Sports Game are...
The nominees for Sports Game of the Year are... EA Sports FIFA 23.
All the drama.
And Sergio Ramos.
A goal!
Mario Strikers Battle League. MLB The Show 22.
Oh, I'm John Chung. Thanks for joining us. Just one out away. Try to close it out. Line drive.
Digits. Something is clicking. That had it.
NBA 2K23. Ali Ali World.
And the winner is Ali Ali World.
Hello, D.I.C.E. Awards. Thank you so much for this award. It is a huge honor to receive it on behalf of the Roll 7 team. I'd just like to say thank you to everyone who's played the game, commented, sent us messages, and supported it to getting this great accolade. I'm just the guy standing here doing a video, but really, Oli Oli wouldn't be what it is without the love, the care, and the effort of the Oli Oli team. That's a lot of people, far too many to name right now. But to those guys, I just want to say thank you so much. Your efforts are greatly appreciated. And it's wonderful to be able to receive this award on behalf of everyone who put their care and attention and love into this project. Thank you so much. I hope you all have a wonderful night. Congratulations to everybody else nominated or receiving the award this evening. Goodbye.
Welcome to the stage, CEO of Valen Studios and one of the minds behind Mario Kart Live, Kartik Bala.
You know, we're all lucky to live in the future. We have the whole of human knowledge in our pocket. We can video chat like the Jetsons, for better or for worse, and virtual reality has come so far that we all consider it a part of everyday life. Long gone are the days of 8-pound headsets and endlessly pounding headaches. Now, with current technology, we're able to seamlessly lose ourselves in other times and worlds. The nominees for Immersive Reality Game of the Year allowed gamers to not just play a game, but feel that they truly exist somewhere else. They are...
The nominees for Immersive Reality Game of the Year are... Cosmonius High.
Wow! You're a natural fan-dimensional.
Dr. Roscopy.
Moss, Book 2. Red Matter 2.
Why would they build a research facility way out here?
Something just doesn't add up. Be careful.
Tentacular.
This guy.
The Last Clockwinder.
Thank you.
And the winner is Red Matter 2.
We've received a distress signal from your crewmate on Strongpen 3. You have a new mission. Find him and bring him home. Do you read me?
Hi. Thank you all for this honor. As a small but mighty team at Vertical Robot, we are truly humbled by the success of Red Matter 2. We have put in countless hours and boundless passion into making this game a reality, and it is truly gratifying to see it resonate so deeply with players. This award is a testament to the hard work and talent of our team, and we are grateful to be recognized among such talented peers. Thank you again so much.
Thanks to mobile games, places like the dentist waiting room or the grocery store checkout line are now battlegrounds where you can kill the most powerful final boss of all time, boredom. Our nominees for Mobile Game of the Year tonight range from blink and you'll miss it card games to dramatic stories told over the course of three entire movies. The nominees are...
The nominees for Mobile Game of the Year are... Diablo Immortal.
Fear my blade.
By holy fire, I'll be redeemed!
Gibbon, Beyond the Trees. Immortality. Marvel Snap.
Avengers!
Assemble.
Coin P.
All right. The winner is Marvel Snap.
Victory.
Hold this. Hold this. Wow, these lights are bright. Sorry, I'm not that prepared. Marvel Snap is the accumulation of millions of ideas, decisions, and I think most importantly, iterations from hundreds of people that all touch the Marvel Snap experience. So first, congratulations to every single person at Second Dinner, and then all the folks at the Marvel Games team and Newverse, and all the players that provide the playing experience for each other, that are making community content, that are forming up tournaments. They're all creating this experience I think we all get to enjoy together. So congratulations to everybody for being a part of that. And then also thank you for everyone that helped us along the way. It was only a few years ago that we started up as a small indie game studio. And lots of people put their faith in us when there was really, really no evidence that they should do so. So thank you very much to, you know, Bill and Ken, the folks at NetEase. Thanks to Jay at Marvel for putting their faith in us. Thanks to all the folks at Second Dinner for putting their careers in our hands. I'm glad we didn't fumble it too bad yet. And thanks to everyone at DICE, who has been like so kind to us and telling us about their experiences of the game, and I guess some cabal in there that voted for the award, something like that. I'm not sure how that works, but thank you. That's it, I guess. Thank you very much. This way.
Distinguished guests, screenwriter of Rogue One, A Star Wars Story, and The Book of Eli, as well as Telltale Games' The Walking Dead, Gary Whitta.
You're very sweet, thank you. Character is where all great storytelling begins and ends. Without characters we can care about, empathize with, or simply love to hate, nothing else we do as storytellers matters. And from a hapless pirate to a father and son still learning how to be a father and son while slaying mythic monsters, this year Game Writers demonstrated once again just how good they've gotten at bringing us characters that linger in the memory long after the final credits have rolled. The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Character are...
The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Character are... Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, Alejandro Vargas.
Welcome to the City of Souls. There are few here to uphold the law, and many of those who resist corruption disappear.
God of War Ragnarok, Atreus.
You can let go now.
Stop thinking like a father for a moment and start thinking like a general.
No. I need to know you'll be okay without me.
God of War Ragnarok, Kratos.
I took my son. When you made me the god I once was.
I...
Do not lie to me again. I was the one who was not ready.
Horizon Forbidden West, Aloy.
I have to find a way to fix it all. And the answer is somewhere out in the Forbidden West.
Return to Monkey Island, Guybrush Threepwood.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood, and this is a story about the time I finally found the secret of Monkey Island.
And the winner is... Kratos, God of War Ragnarok.
Then why? Why? What is it you want to tell me? Tried to walk this path with you.
Congratulations.
We follow you on every whim.
But you don't believe in any of it.
And still, I follow. Because all that matters is that you are safe.
Thank you. I promise I will make this quick. Wait, was everyone else's teleprompter a stopwatch? I always start with my family, because I am the sum of them. Starting with my mother, who is once again, even my mother said, don't be up there blubbering and crying and shit. You're making the judges look weak. Who is currently kicking cancer in the ass again. My brother, Dr. Jeffrey Judge, and his beautiful family, my children. I'm fortunate enough to have my son Cameron here with me, and that makes him my favorite son. Take some pictures, them tickets weren't free. My best friend, my ride or die, my ace, Boom. My wife, who, when everything else is topsy-turvy, I come home and I'm safe. I love you. And hopefully, by mentioning you this time, my quarantine will only be 3 days instead of 5 days. She knows how to deal with me better than anyone, and it's an hour and a half a day, no more. Thank you, Sony Santa Monica, Yumi Yang, the revelatory Mr. Eric Williams, Matt Rich, every single person at Sony Santa Monica, Sony, PlayStation, all of our affiliates who have left their love print on this masterpiece. I feel blessed but almost guilty accepting this, because God of War and God of War Ragnarok was a cumulative effort of everyone. But I got to be in this volume with a group of human beings who were as willing or more willing than I was to put their heartache, their struggles, their joy out there for the world to see, and did it unabashedly, did it willingly, did it proudly and with conviction. And I really want to accept this as a cast award. It made those days in the volume so special and so loving and so supportive and funny and sometimes smelly. But it was truly a joy. Sonny, your time is coming, man. I want to thank you. I've made no secret of the great pain it caused me every time one of my children left the house to go on their own adventures. And you allowed me to have a kid again, to have what I enjoy most in the world is interacting with my children. You allowed me that. And bro, I can't wait to see how far you fly, man. I am greatly appreciative, truly humbled, less than 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mario. But our princess is in another castle. That used to be what passed for story in video games. Of course, Nintendo's come a long way since then. Now the other castle is in 3D. So I'm never working for Nintendo. But in truth, since the days of the earliest text adventures, game makers have relied on story to greatly enrich the interactive worlds they create. And today, by making the player an active participant rather than simply a passive observer, we can create a unique connection between audience and story that's only possible in the medium of games. The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Story are...
The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Story are... Elden Ring.
I have long observed the lands between. This world is in dire need of repair, and death indiscriminate.
God of War, Ragnarok.
My story doesn't end hiding in these woods. I should be out there, finding out who I am, who Loki is.
I will not allow you to pick a fight with gods.
I was a teenage exocolonist. Immortality.
I found you and I made you what you are.
He's not who you think he is.
There was an accident at the park.
Norco.
And the winner is... God of War Ragnarok.
Tell me.
I can't talk about it, but I just need you to trust me.
Do what is necessary, not because it is written.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Look at that. Thank you. Ariel and I are honored to be up here representing a very large and incredible narrative team
The names that were on that screen do not represent all the people who worked on this game, who put their heart and soul into the narrative of this game. Wow. I just want to thank Eric, Scott, Yumi, Corey, oh my gosh, there's so many people, and now my mind's going blank, of course. It was you, all of our content, technical, production, and QA teams. Thank you for believing and supporting the narrative, having our backs when we had to make tough decisions. thank you to PlayStation Visual Arts, Dialogue, Music, all of our external groups. It was a huge effort, and we couldn't have made this game without you. Thank you to Sony PlayStation for Santa Monica Studio leadership, facilities, IT. It literally wouldn't have been possible to make this game without all of your efforts just to get us doing it. I also want to thank our fans. This was a challenging cycle that anybody in this room can tell you. Everything changed for how we make games. So our fans, your encouragement, your kind words really meant the world to, I think, all of us as we were trying to develop this thing. And finally, I want to thank my family. Thank you for your unwavering support when I chose this really crazy career. And Suzanne, James, I love you. Thank you, everybody.
Keep it going, everybody. Thank you. Was that so hard to say something about Greg once in a while? As many of you know, I podcast for a living and don't like teleprompters. So one thing I want to do real quick is invite the Dice Scholars out here. If Meha and Rory could come out. They've been giving... Where's Meha? Meha! This bit doesn't work. I'm ad-libbing, but I need Meha. There she is. Thank you very much. They're Dice Scholars.
Are you proud of yourself?
They've been doing a great job. They will be here tonight later on. So what we need to make sure everybody knows is that Rory wants to work at Riot. So Jackie Collins, I know you're here somewhere. You need to... And then Meha really wants to meet Tim Schafer. And Tim, I know it's a big night for you, but if you could just say hey at some point to her. Don't just wave like the King of England from the back. That's not, when you're at the after party, they'll find you. But thank you both so much for all your work tonight, all right? No problem. Thank you. All right, go away now. Jeez Louise, you know, you do one ad lib.
Shoo them away.
You know, well, I got Tim over here, you know what I mean? From his gold, you know, I don't want. Let's get back on script, everybody. Here we are, the last awards of the night.
The Outstanding Achievement in Game Direction and Game of the Year. These are the two you'll no doubt be tweeting, Snapchatting, TikToking, and maybe even talking to someone face-to-face about.
Ooh, yeah, face-to-face. That's not a thing. Well, no.
We're literally doing it right now.
They are paying us to do it right now, though.
True. Well, please welcome to the stage from Bethesda, the director of the highly anticipated Starfield and Hall of Fame recipient, Todd Howard.
Everyone here knows that game development is never a straight path. It can sometimes be a winding and rocky road as designers, artists, programmers, and producers all travel together to create something special. Tonight is a reminder that making video games is a collaborative journey. But everyone needs a guide down that path who makes sure that everyone's work comes together into something greater than the individual parts. Here are the nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Game Direction.
The nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Game Direction are Elden Ring, God of War, Ragnarok.
In your
lifetimes has anyone ever worshipped you? Can you even imagine that kind of love? We don't care about anything.
Horizon Forbidden West. Immortality.
Rehearsal scene 43 through 44.
When I saw Miss Marcel, she had a spark. I see great things for her future.
Tunic.
And the winner is Elden Ring.
It's a pleasure receiving this award. As a director, I'm really, really happy about this.
ただですね、このマイルドリンクの作品はですね、僕一人の力ではなかなかできなくてですね、頼りになるCOディレクターのチーム、それは谷村さんであるとか、石崎さんであるとかをはじめとしたチームにすごく助けられました。
But I'm myself alone not able to complete this project. Of course, I worked with so many, you know, colleagues, especially those two co-directors, Tanimura-san and Ishizaki-san. Without their support, without their big help, it's almost impossible to complete this project. So I really want to share this joy of this award with them. Thank you very much.
Distinguished guests, the founder of Respawn Entertainment, makers of the upcoming Star Wars Jedi Survivor, Vince Zampella.
Hey, Tim, can I get a wave, too? All right, welcome, everyone. We finally reached the culmination of the evening. I could go on about the importance of games. I think we all know how lucky we are. This collection of amazing games and creators here tonight, I feel so fucking lucky to be up here. I don't think I'm supposed to curse. Oops. I could go on about how every game nominated tonight deserves its own award. I could go on about how much video games have changed all of our lives and given us opportunities we'd never thought possible. But right now, we all want to get to the after party, so let's do this. Let's see.
The nominees for Game of the Year are Elden Ring.
Greetings, traveler from beyond the fog.
God of War, Ragnarok.
Beyond the monster who kills without cause.
Is it a God of War you can't find?
Horizon Forbidden West. Stray. Vampire Survivors.
All right, all so good, but let's see who you picked. The winner is Elden Ring.
Thank you so much.
フロムソフトウェアの、そしてバンダイナムコの、そしてフロックネーションをはじめとする外部の協力会社の皆さん、そして素晴らしい神話を執筆してくれたジョージ・アーラル・マーティンさん、その素晴らしいですね、私の尊敬するエルデンチームのみんなと、この喜びを分かち合いたいというふうに思います。
Again, I would like to share this joy of this great award with all Elden Ring team members, including all members at the From Software, our partner Bandai Namco, as well as many collaborators such as Frog Nation, and last not but least, George R. Martin.
で、またですね、このゲーム、ユーザーさんですね、このゲームを遊んでくれて、楽しんでくれて、支持してくれたすべてのユーザーさんにですね、大きな感謝を伝えたいです。毎回ですね、こういう場所で同じ話になってしまうんですけれども、ユーザーさんへの感謝だけはですね、何度伝えても、あるいは強調しても足りないかなというふうに感じてますので、ここで改めて伝えさせてください。
And finally, I would like to express my utmost gratitude to the many users who have played, enjoyed, and supported this work.I'm afraid I'm talking about this same thing over and over again in occasion like this, but I feel that no matter how many times I say it or how much I emphasize it, I can never say enough about our gratitude to our users.
優しくないゲームだと思うんですけど、そんなゲームがですね、こんなに多くのユーザーさんに遊んでいただけて、支持していただけるって、本当に幸せに思ってます。今後もですね、我々のできる限りということになってしまいますけれども、より面白いゲーム作っていくつもりでおりますので、ぜひ今後ともよろしくお願いします。
Well, you know, Elden Ring is not user-friendly, you know, in the first...When users look at it for the first time. So, you know, I really, really want to appreciate it once again to the users. A lot of users keep playing this game, and that we will continue working on a great game.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
He keeps yelling, Greg, you know what I mean?
It's a pity. Oh.
I'll take it. Thanks, Linda. You know what I mean?
It's for me.
No. I mean, seems like they should make DLC for that Elden Ring game, if you ask me.
There is DLC.
Is there?
Yeah.
Probably should do some more of it. We did it, folks! That's a wrap for the 26th Annual D.I.C.E. Award. Congratulations to all the amazing nominees and winners this evening. We are in awe of all that you do.
And this celebration isn't over. The D.I.C.E. Awards After Party sponsored by Unity will be happening right here. So feel free to mingle, but please allow for the quick changeover from ceremony to party.
And Tim, go talk to the lady. You know what I mean? Yeah, yeah. The bars are just outside. The doors are open. They are fully stocked. And I'm officially starting my countdown to Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom. Let's light the candle. It's time.